Hello, everybody, and welcome to Exercise 7-12. This is journalizing various different receivable transactions. So the reason why I'm going to do this one is it's a little bit different because this is a company that is recording transactions net. What does that mean? They're going to be booking that sale transaction, assuming the discount. So let's take a look at here at July 1st. So James Garfield sells to Warden Harding merchandise having a sales price of $8,000. So they don't give us the cost of goods sold or the inventory, but they are giving us the sales price. So when they're going to record the sale, they're going to debit accounts receivable and they're going to credit sales. So the amount of the accounts receivable is going to be 8,000. And because we're going to subtract out the discount, the way that we're going to record these transactions are at net. So if I'm recording it sales and receivable net, it's assuming that they're going to be taking the discount. So I'm going to debit accounts receivable here for $7,840. I'm going to credit sales, and this is to record sales to Warren Harding Company. Okay, let's go to July 5th. Accounts receivable gross are factored with Andrew Jackson Credit Corporation without recourse at a financing charge of 9%. So if you want to learn a little bit more about with or without recourse, I would refer you here to without recourse, this exercise 7-19. When we go through and we sell an account receivable without recourse, we're going to be getting cash, and at the same time, we're going to be taking the account receivable off of our books. So let's go through and read this a little bit more. So accounts receivable are factored with Andrew Jackson without recourse at a financing charge of 9%. Cash is received for the proceeds. Collections are handled by the finance company. These accounts were all past the discount period. So what we're going to need to do is before we go through and sell these, let's kind of think about what happened originally. When these transactions were recorded, we debited AR and we credited sales. But the amount that we were going to record them at was going to be at net, or the sale of 9,000 less the 2% discount, or here at 8,820. So what I can do here first is before I go through and record the sale, is I can come up here and I can basically say, okay, we're going to debit accounts receivable, and then we're going to credit something called sales discounts lost. Believe it or not, this is a revenue account. I wouldn't personally do it this way, but have fun. Okay, so now I'm ready to sell the receivable because now these receivables are actually at 9,000. So once I debit AR, so this is what I originally did over here. So now that I have debited AR for the 180, I am now ready to factor the receivables. Okay, so over here, I'm putting in this 180, so my AR is now at 9,000. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this 9,000 off of my books. However, I'm not going to get the full amount of the 9,000. Rather, they're charging me a financing charge of 9%. So the amount of the cash proceeds I'm going to be receiving is gonna be accounts receivable less the 9%, or over here, a total of 8,190. So here I'm gonna get 8,190, and then my journal entry is here is going to be for a debit to loss on sale of receivables. And this is to be record factor with Andrew Jackson Credit Corporation. Okay. So let's go take a look at number 9. Specific accounts receivable of $9,000 gross are pledged to Alf Landing Credit Corp as security for a loan at $6,000 at a finance charge of 6% of the amount of the loan. The finance company will make the collections. All the receivables are past the discount period. Well, notice here that even though I'm not actually selling the receivables like I was before, I still need to reflect that I'm going to basically record this accounts receivable sales discount lost of 180 on each side, because right over here, I need to bring that receivable up to the amount because the receivables are past the discount period, meaning the entire thing is due. So over here, now that basically it's got to say over here, now this is a loan. So I'm borrowing $6,000. So I'm borrowing $6,000. But am I going to be receiving that full amount? And the answer is no. I'm going to be assessed a finance charge of 6% of the loan payable. So this here is going to be 6,000 times 6%. So the cash received is going to be 5,640. Okay. So my difference here is going to be to interest expense. And if you want to see a good question to kind of look at if we're actually pledging money against receivables, you take a look at exercise 7-15. This is assigning accounts receivable. So right over here, we're going to have here, this is going to be interest expense, also the financing charge. Okay. And so this is to record loan from, who is this from? This is from Alf Landon. Okay. Now we get to December 29th. Warren Harding notifies Garfield that it is bankrupt and will only pay 10% of its account. So this is going back here to July 1st. So what I also have to do here is now that Warren Harding has gone bankrupt. So right over here with the Warren Harding receivable, let's take a look at this here. So right over here, I had 7,840. So what I need to do first is that I need to reinstate that discount. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to debit accounts receivable. I'm going to credit sales discounts lost. And this is going to be here for 160. Once I do this here, my accounts receivable has been reinstated over here to a total of $8,000. Okay. So what I'm being told here is that they're only going to pay 10% of the balance. So the amount of the receivable that I'm actually only going to be collecting is going to be 10% of this amount. So what I need to do is I need to write off the receivable. Whenever I write off the receivable, I'm going to debit allowance for doubtful accounts, and I'm going to credit accounts receivable for that write-off. So to get from 8,000 to 800, I'm going to need a credit for 7,200. My debit is to allowance for doubtful accounts, and this is to record the write-off of the Harding receivable. So that is your problem 7-12. I did go a little bit on the faster side for this question, but I would suggest going through and taking a look at exercise 7-15, and then also I would take a look at 7-19. So I'll see you on the next video. Have a great one.